Good afternoon, and welcome back to my series on Invisible Ink. This is Doc Stout. I've continued the say from the last video. We were successful in our last mission. I'm going to go right back in, and I've already selected an op. Going to head to St. John's to hit the FTM vault. Security level is guarded. Takes me 8 hours to get there.
They're rebooting their regional servers and aren't recording the security telemetry from this installation. There's a vault on site, probably an executive slush fund. Information is power, operator, so try and get as much intel as you can find.
All right, heading on in. I kind of wish that this had been a detention center. I don't have a whole lot of confidence about this run. All right, we'll move Deckard up. There's clearly one exit. Looks like there's probably a camera or something, so I can take Internationale to the side of the door and use her ability to look for it. All right, she can also hit both consoles, and we'll go here into Incognita and hack the camera. What's that thing? That is a nanofabricator. I don't know that I can afford anything in there yet, but that might be something to hit to maybe salvage something out of this particular agency. I'm at the experience cap, so that doesn't matter so much to me. Guess we'll hack the laser emitter for the moment. And try and use every last one. Now, just in case a guard's about to come through that door, we'll leave Internationale where he is. Where she is. Alright. Does look like there's a guard there. I think for now, I prefer to leave the guard alone. I prefer to hit the guards only as a last resort. Move Internationale up to the side, I guess. What is that? Oh, okay, that's a nanofabricator I'd already seen. So we got a lot of doors. Take as much opportunity as I can while the alarm level's still zero. Try and find the exit. I have a history of missing important things by not opening a door. In this case, I didn't miss anything, and even if I had, it just would have been a console. Oh, there's the exit. All right. Well, that's going to make this run a heck of a lot easier. Peek through this door, and what have we here? That's a console database. So, I can reasonably assume that there's more than one way out of this room. And it looks like there's the elevator where reinforcements will be coming if we're here that long. Let's get a good look at the rest of this room, though. I guess we'll move Internationale as far back as I can. Not quite ready to hit this room yet. Though it's nice to see that I can take that guard out and immediately go to the elevator. Guard in here, too. Bring Internationale up a little bit just in case anything goes wrong. I'm not sure if the guard can see the door or not. Let's find out.
You see that?
He totally did see that. Alright. We'll hack the safe and set Deckard to melee reaction. Melee reaction means that if the guard comes to this square, I'm just going to tase him. That's about all I got. We'll at least get a safe out of this run. Assuming I don't dally too much. Alright, so some new cameras are coming up. Okay, couple tasks. First, let's turn that camera off. We'll steal from this guy. Question is, do I want to get cute That give me 2 AP left. Cost me 5 to get here. No useful items in the safe. Where's he gonna go? I forgot that cost me an action point. That may have been a huge mistake. Alright, just in case it was, let me move Internationale up. Maybe he'll turn the other way. He totally turned the other way. Alright, so we know that guard's gonna come back through. So I can't stay in this room. But I can get to the other side of the door and shut it so he won't see me. We also know that his patrol route is not particularly efficient, so I should be able to hide Internationale here. And I'll have Deckard as backup just in case he sees her as he pops out of the door. He totally saw her. Alright. It's mistakes like this. At least I planned for this. Ugh. His cone of sight means that Internationale can't move at all. Am I going to be stuck using a med gel? I can get clever here, maybe. See what happens if I use the cloak.
I lost.
Shut the door on him. Okay. That is the messiest, most wasteful way I could come up with to actually survive this room. We'll set her to melee reaction and get Deckard back over to where he started. Tased. Okay, the other guard's about to get up. Let's see if he had any useful stuff on him. He's got a pass card. Hacked camera. Getting pretty close to needing to bug out. Ugh. Man, do I want the stuff that's in this room. Alright, let's, no guts, no glory. Let's try and get that room. Scan for wireless devices. Man, I don't have nearly enough to hit all that. Kind of wish I'd been able to hit that console. Maybe I was able to and just forgot. Alright, well, at least we know where our exit point is. Just gotta avoid getting trapped. Which unfortunately is a little easier said than done. Move Deckard and Internationale to the sides of the door. Start working on that first laser emitter. Next turn we'll be able to take it down. Excuse me. Internationale here. His taser's ready. Let's lure the guard out. Don't need to lure the guard out. Is he stationary? He is stationary. Yeah, let's see if I can actually get around him without hitting him at all.
I think somebody's down.
Oh, yeah. Well. That's going to be a problem. It's going to take us 2 turns minimum. We can both get in the room. I don't like this at all. We don't have nearly enough power. And the alarm level's getting pretty high. Stuck right here. I can at least turn that laser emitter off. Okay, now there's a guard facing that way. That's really pretty bad for me. This location is noticed. Can't do anything at the moment.
Looking around.
Okay, security's gonna close in there. I gotta give him another turn. Wait a minute. What happens if I... Yeah, let's set her to melee reaction. It's gonna start spawning extra guards real soon. Gotta get what I can and bug out. Take every little bit of credits I can. Open the security boxes. Search the safes. Alright. That's more turns, I think, than I want to deal with. I think it's time to start making our way out.
Warning.
That may have been a mistake. Alright. Main priority now is getting to the elevator, which is easier said than done because a new guard has spawned.
Warning.
Oh, okay. International's blocking the way. We're not sure where that other guard went either. Let's at least shut the door so they won't immediately see us when they wake up. We gotta get through this room as fast as possible. Okay, we know he's gonna head there. Deckard's cloak is on cooldown. Yeah, this is bad. I can't have her hide there. Wait for him to move. Oh, there's another one. Yeah, all of our exits are pretty well blocked. It's about to get worse. Says I can use the cloak, though. Alright. I don't know that I'm actually going to make it through this, but... give it a shot. Yeah, I gotta move, because it's gonna start spawning elites. Get her out of the way so I can get deeper into the room. Hide him here. End turn. Elevator is 3 rooms away. Okay, we'll hide there. Get Deckard in to here. So long as nobody sees me, I should be able to run into the elevator. Yeah, enforcers are coming. Gotta bug out. And Deckard doesn't even have to run. International also doesn't even have to run. Let's take no chances, though. And get Deckard. We didn't get very much out of this, and the missions are going to get harder from here, but it's time to escape. Alright, didn't get any intelligence. Got some credits. That's about it. Alright, well, I guess I will continue this run. I didn't actually get to use the nanofabricator. I've got 1660 credits, but I'm going to start to encounter enemies with armor or other things that I need to deal with. So I guess join me next time. I'm going to continue this until I have to actually retire this agency, which I fear is going to be soon, because I don't have a third member yet and I don't have any gear. All I've got is money. This is Doc Stout with Invisible Ink, signing out for the day.